Today we will see the analysis of medium transmission line. So in medium transmission line we have lumped RLC circuit, and it is represented in four types of model. First is receiving end capacitor model, or we can say load condenser method. Second one is sending end capacitor model or source condenser method. Third one is nominal T method, and fourth one is nominal pi, or we can say split condenser method. So first we will see the receiving end capacitor model. So in receiving end capacitor model, it overestimates the effect of capacitance, and we can also say it is a overcompensation method. Okay, so our receiving end capacitance model is known as a overcompensation method. Okay, so this is the diagram of the receiving end capacitor model. See, in the diagram you can see the capacitor is connected toward the load, means capacitor is connected at the load side, okay, means receiving side. So it is known as a receiving end capacitance model. Here Z impedance is drawn here, capacitor is here. So what will be the value of IS? IS equal to by KCL, IS equal to IC plus IR, okay, and IC is equal to J omega C VR, and VC equal to, by applying KVL, VS equal to VR plus IS into R plus JXL. This is from KVL, and VS equal to VR, means VS equal to VR, and resistive voltage drop is equal to IS into R, okay, and reactive voltage drop is IS into XS, and impedance voltage drop is equal to IS into Z, which is known as the total voltage drop. Okay, now ABCD parameter, means we have connected this diagram by arranging Z, and here it is we have connected Y, and calculating ABCD, and this ABCD is calculated by individual, means at a time impedance is connected, and second time this is the value of ABCD. I will show you how to calculate the ABCD parameter by individual. Okay, so see, this is a diagram. We will only connect impedance here. This is IS, and this is IR, this is VS, VR. Okay, so in this condition IS equal to IR, we know that IS equal to IR, means this current will flow through here, which is equal to IS equal to IR. And what will be the VS, means applying KVL here, so VS is equal to VR plus Z into IR, Z into IR. Okay, now we know that the ABCD formula, VS is equal to AVR plus BIR, and IS is equal to CVR plus DIR. Okay, here we have written minus minus. Okay, so what will the value of A according to this formula? What will be the value of A? A is equal to 1, and B is equal to Z, and C is equal to here VR is not present as of, so we will write as 0, and D is equal to 1, and we write here in matrix form, so it will be equal to 1 Z 0 1. Okay, and second time ABCD parameter of this Y, okay, this is IS and this is IR, this VS and VR. Okay, so here VS equal to VR, means same voltage is will be present here, so VS equal to VR, and IS equal to, this is IC, IS equal to IC plus IR, so IS is equal to, value of IC is Y into VR plus IR. Okay, now saying this formula, the value of A is 1, okay, and here IS is not present, so B is equal to 0, D equal to, sorry, C equal to y and d equal to 1. So our in matrix form will be 1 0 y 1. Okay, so in this way you will get this formula, this form 1 0 1 1 0 y 1. Now multiplying this both, we will get 1 plus yz, z, y, 1. Okay, means 1 into 1, 1 plus y into z is yz. Same for first row, first column, first row, second column. So, we will get 1 plus yz, z, y, and 1. Okay, so in the diagram, you can see that in the matrix form, you can see A is not equal to D. And AD minus BC means AD minus BC equal to 1, which is known as a reciprocal network, and this is not symmetrical. Okay, now second one is, sending and capacitance method. Okay, so in this method, it underestimates the effect of capacitance. Okay, and here capacitor is connected toward the source, toward the sending end side, or we can say it is connected to at the source end. Okay, so from the diagram, it is clear that IS is equal to IC plus IR, IC is equal to G omega C into VS, and VS equal to VC, means same voltage will be present here, and VS equal to, by applying KVL, we get VR plus IR, R plus JXL. Okay, and ABCD parameter here, same, the individual capacitance, means individual Y, shunt capacitance, ABCD parameter will be 10Y1, and for impedance, it will be 1Z01. Multiplying this, get 1ZY and 1 plus ZY. Okay, so here A is not equal to D, which is not symmetrical, and AD minus BC equal to 1, which is reciprocal. Okay, third one is nominal T method. Okay, which is also known as a middle condenser method. So in the nominal T method, you can see that impedance is divided by 2. Okay, here you divided by 2, and capacitance is connected. Same for IS equal to IC plus IR, VC is equal to G omega C into VC, and VC is equal to voltage across capacitance is equal to VR plus IR into Z by 2, and VS is equal to, applying KVL here, so VR plus Z by 2 into IS plus Z by 2 into IR. Okay, and the ABCD parameter of this given as this is for impedance only, the single impedance, the ABCD parameter is this 1 Z by 2 0 1. For capacitance, it is 1 0 Y 1, again for single impedance 1 Z by 2 0 1, and by calculate, by multiplying both these three, we get 1 plus ZY by 2, Z 1 plus ZY y by 4, Y and 1 plus ZY by 2. So A is equal to D. A is equal to D, which is symmetrical, and AD minus BC equal to 1, okay, which is reciprocal. Okay, and last one is nominal pi method. So in nominal pi, capacitance is connected at the both end, and divided by 2 we have taken, and here between this impedance is connected. Okay, so now ABCD parameter will be, for this single capacitance, single shunt capacitance, the ABCD parameter is 10Y by 2 1, as the same we have previously shown in for the first type of medium transmission line. Same way we have to solve this. Again, the impedance, single impedance, we have ABCD parameter 1Z01, and for last capacitance, single shunt capacitance 10Y by 2 1. Okay, we have find out the ABCD parameter individually. Okay, so by calculating this, we get 1 plus ZY by 2, ZY 1 plus ZY by 4, and 1 plus ZY by 2. Here A is equal to D, and AD minus BC equal to 1, which is reciprocal, and A is equal to D is symmetrical. Okay, and one important point regarding this type of medium transmission line, The load condenser method is used for the improving power factor of the load. This is an important point. Load condenser method is used for the improving power factor of the load. Source condenser method is used for the improving power factor of the source. And nominal T used for the improving power factor of the transmission line. And nominal pi method is used for the improving power factor of both source and load. Okay, so this is an important point regarding the medium transmission line.